What is up, guys? So in today's video, we have a couple news topics. The first one is obviously the big thing that's been happening this week, the inauguration. Joe Biden is now officially the President of the United States, and Kamala Harris is the Vice President. Origami face masks are apparently a thing. Intel, like the computer company, they're having really good sales, and Mercedes is making a new SUV that is trying to overtake some other big SUV companies. But without further ado, as always, I'm sorry if there's any screaming in the background. That's my family just existing, and let's get into it. Okay, so I don't know how closely you guys have been following this whole thing with the inauguration, but personally, I've been following it fairly closely just because I think it's important for people to understand what's happening in this country, right? So, to start things off, the transition of power, it went horribly, you know, like, Trump tried to sue his way to getting the presidency for a second time. He tried everything in the book, and the man just lost, and he couldn't accept that he lost, right? And then for legal reasons, I'm not saying that he started the riot, but he pretty much incited a riot on the U.S. Capitol, which is one of the most horrid things we've seen in U.S. history. Not the most horrid, just to be completely clear, but it was pretty bad. Well, I'm recording this on February 20th, so earlier today, he flew out in Air Force One to Florida, I guess to stay in his country club while he's no longer the President of the United States. But on a later side, Joe Biden's now the president. He is the oldest president ever. I mean, that's pretty cool. It's nice because the man knows what he's doing. Like, he's putting us back in the Paris Agreement, which for those of you who don't know what that is, that's basically going to try and cap climate change to some extent, whereas Trump pulled us out of that, and the country, but like global warming's been going batshit insane because of it. So in other news, apparently origami face masks are a thing. I didn't really read into the article because I didn't care, but it's like a different way to make a face mask. I think it's slightly more effective, and I know it's probably a lot more cash, like economical friendly. Yeah, it's better for monetary stuff, and it's a lot better for the environment because it's made out of paper, not cloth. Or else, I'm pretty sure it's not made out of cloth. I could be completely wrong on that, but like I said, I didn't read into the article. Too bad. I mean, I'll be highlighting it on the screen now if it is made out of cloth, but I don't think it is. But that's kind of cool. You know, Intel, the computer company, like the people that make the CPUs, they've been having a really good year, and they're predicting the top sales charts, which makes sense considering that now everyone and their mom has to have a everyone and their grandma has to have a computer because of everything. It would make sense that happened. I'm surprised, correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure AMD is also having a good year. But, you know, like, general computer brands like HP and Dell, they don't use AMD processors. I don't know why. They're actually cheaper than Intel to some extent, but they use them. They don't, so that's an L for AMD. And then another thing, Mercedes is making a new SUV, right? So it's not that big of a deal. Normally it's not that big of a deal, my bad, because, like, Mercedes makes SUVs all the time now. That's one of their new things. Actually, really, all of the luxury car market has just been going to SUVs. Even Lamborghini has an SUV. It kind of weird, and I find it funny when rappers flex their Lamborghini SUVs, even though that's the cheapest car that Lamborghini produces. just got to get that off my chest. But the special thing with this one is that it's an electric SUV, right? So Mercedes is hoping this will be like their Tesla competitor. Now, I'm pretty pro-Tesla. I'm planning on putting some money into the stock of Tesla. In a Tesla stock? Yes, I can use big words. So, you know, I kind of don't want it to throw over Tesla because that would kind of screw me over if I end up putting money in it, which, like I said, I plan to. I mean, I don't see Tesla going anywhere, and all I see them doing is up. I mean, eventually they're literally going to be up because they'll be on Mars, like, I mean, that's gonna be amazing. Just, like, that's the biggest marketing stunt ever, you know? Like, Tesla, they shot one of their cars into orbit, and that was, like, would have been a $1 billion marketing campaign all for free because they were testing SpaceX rockets. But, you know, that's pretty interesting just in general that Mercedes is trying to compete with that. You know, the Porsche Taycan picture on the screen now, that's trying to compete with it. I mean, I feel like it's good that other companies are making EVs and whatnot. I just feel like if you want it to be successful, you... See, this is my problem. It's not with the actual car. You know, I love electric cars. I want to own one day. But, like, in my opinion, the problem with it is that they all use different chargers to some extent. Like, you have Tesla doing their own thing. And that's just going to probably be the way it is. They'll just be using superchargers. But then, like, with the Mercedes, though, I'm not too sure on this. Don't quote me, but I'm pretty sure it'll be using a different charging station than the Porsche. Like, I feel like the person that's going to come out on top of this, like, whole, like, electric car thing is going to be the one that has the most robust charging system, because that's really the only way it's going to work. And I'm sure by the end of this, there'll be, like, three main, like, charging systems, and they'll be all over the place. And, I mean, that'll be cool, but, like, I feel like, I don't know, man, we should all, I feel like people should just, see, if Tesla would actually go along with this, I feel like it would be best if they all just used superchargers and just dealt with it, because Tesla's already made that whole thing, and it's in existence. Now, is that me being a bit of a fanboy? Abso-frickin-lutely, you know, 100%. But do I still think it's a good idea for everyone to use, like, one charger brand? One or two charger brands, you know? But just everyone just use the same kind of plug, you know? It's like, in your house, okay? It doesn't matter what electric company you use. Unless you live in different countries and whatnot, you all pretty much have the same kind of wall plug, you know? It's like, at least in the US, it's like the two-pronged one. That's just the standard, you know? So it would make sense for, like, electric cars to charge like that. You can use different brands and whatnot, but they all use the same plug. That's going to do it for this video. I just covered a few things. This was actually a 10-minute video. It didn't feel like that. It'll probably be a bit shorter in post and whatnot. But that's going to do it for the video. Joe Biden's now the president. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.